Hello, this is Eric. Look at this. Here's a mini TV I made. It's so cute, isn't it? Its display resolution is 280 by 240 and audio is also output through a small 1W speaker. Each of the video and audio files is loaded from the SD card and processed separately. It works very well. I prepared 20 videos for this demo and put them on the SD card beforehand. Use the touchscreen to change the channels. For example, left swipe moves to the next channel. Conversely, a right swipe takes you to the previous channel. How's it? Is it usable? This system configuration consists of ESP32 and 280 by 240 display, max 983578, 1W mini speaker and SD card, that's it. I'm using a custom board, but I believe you can make enough on the breadboard for your own project. My project is based on the mini retro TV project. He's not only the author of the Arduino GFX, but also makes plays video and audio on the ESP32 without any problems. This is awesome. Not only does it play at 30fps, but the audio is also played without any problems. So there is no problem with video and audio sync. One thing, it's just not the MP4 video file we usually think of. Decoding video files directly is not possible with ESP32 resources. It's additionally necessary to separate the MJPEG file and audio from the video file. Nevertheless, this is a lot of fun. What I did was simply add a code to play the next video clip using the touchscreen. For my code to work, this project must work first, so be sure to try this project first. You can get my code from my GitHub repository. In order for this project to be successful, you need a display that operates at 80 MHz. A display using the ST7789 is highly recommended. If you have a display that uses a different graphics IC, you can also re-encode the video to match its full speed. I assume that you have already set up your system through this post. What we need from this author's project is MJPEG 2 task audio 1 task. As the title of this, a total of 3 tasks are running while playing video and audio. Independently, the audio task reads AAC or MP3 files from SD card and plays them continuously until the end of the file. The video task also reads the MJPEG file, decodes each frame into JPEG, and draws it on the screen. This is how the whole system works. The MJPEG to task audio 1 task project is here. I have installed all the necessary libraries he mentioned. I only changed my display settings and wrapped the rest. Let me build this and upload it to my ESP32. To test 30fps video can be played without any problem, let's download the sample video and test it. You can download the sample video here. I got a 1 minute in 640 by 360 resolution. Now make a file in MJPEG format to fit my display using FFMPEG. And then the audio format is set to AAC and the only audio file is extracted separately. This is all from the mini retro TV post. I just increased the volume by 5 dB. It's done. Let's put this on the SD card and check the playback result. It's playing with audio. Nice. If playback does not work, check the file name again. I didn't change any path or file name, so it should be the same as the post. Let's speed up the video. The important is the playback result. As soon as the video ends, the playback result is displayed on the screen. You can see that the expected FPS and the actual FPS are the same. The result is amazing. I think it's great that ESP32 plays 30fps videos without any problems. That's enough, but I have added a few things here so you can play a variety of videos with one SD card. You can get this source code from my GitHub repository. My display supports a touchscreen, so I tried to make it possible to change the playing video by using the touch action. If you don't have a touchscreen on your display, adding an extra button to have the same function is another way. A task has been added to receive touch events. Here, it receives and handles touch events. Since I'm using the screen in landscape mode, the direction of the touch changes like this. If you look at the last part of my code, you can see that the video index is saved to the internal partition using preferences library and labeled. I tried to delete all tasks and reallocate memory instead of labeling, but all failed. I know this is not a fancy way, but this is how I changed channels. Each video and audio have the same name, just the folder name is the channel index. I made a total of 20 video files in MJPEG and AAC format. Finally, I'm making a simple housing case using Lego. Let me build it fast. For reference, this is Lego Classic 11717. Nothing special, this is just for fun. It's interesting to build a video player with ESP32. Honestly, I didn't think this would be possible, but it works in the end. That's it for today. I'll be back with more exciting projects. See you on the next project.